Vision of a new South Asia. We say every single human being has the potential and the right to live a decent life. Do we really believe in this? We have been saying this for ages. I would like to make it even simpler and raise the question as to whether I would like to imagine a new South Asia and a new world where every single individual on earth will have the possibility of living a decent life. One simple and obvious requirement for a decent life is that no individual should be hungry or die of hunger. Therefore, before we go too far into complex and complicated imaginations, can we think of a South Asia and a world where no human being would be compelled to die of hunger? This should be quite easy to achieve because it is admitted that the world, the earth, has capacity to produce enough food for all human beings, for all human beings and more. We know very well that over the centuries, the processes of production, forms of distribution and consumption have not looked at the need to sustain the earth's capacity or nature's capacity to continually regenerate itself and its resources, the resources that are necessary for survival of humans and all other living beings. Therefore, most of these processes have been so designed that they deplete these resources and destroy the nature's ability to regenerate itself. In spite of such massive destruction, almost throughout the history of what is described as human advancement, it has still been possible for the world to say that the ability of the world to produce enough to feed all is not yet lost. Therefore, it should be possible to imagine a world and a South Asia where no one goes hungry, at least where no human person dies of hunger. I also say that it should be quite easy, since some simple birds such as crows may not be dying of hunger. At least I guess that the number of crows that die of hunger should be less than the number of human beings dying of hunger. This I believe is because crows are free to feed themselves when and wherever they are hungry. They do not have to earn money to pay for their food, neither do they have to have permission to eat from wherever there is food if they are hungry. Therefore, we human beings, who are assumed to be more intelligent, rational and capable, should be able to think of an arrangement where all human beings should be free to eat from wherever there is food, even when they do not have the money to pay for it. Or as the crows do, they should be able to move to places where they could find food freely. All human beings will look for food or will produce food to avoid being hungry if they are given the possibility. In dealing with the right and the potential of every human being to have a decent life, I would like to begin by looking at the possibility of all human beings having food, because if we can imagine a process that would help us in South Asia and in the world to ensure that all human beings will have this requirement fulfilled, it would be easy to envisage the more comprehensive processes that are necessary to ensure that all will have decent lives. Giving people the possibility of using their potential to be free of hunger would mean that they would also have the possibility of using their potentials to achieve better lives in other respects too. A simple way of achieving this is for all those who are controlling the processes of food production and distribution, and all those who have ownership over the nature's resources necessary for food production, such as land, water, machinery, technology, science, trade, etc., and all those who design systems, rules, regulations to agree that the way they utilize these should ensure that all human beings should have food in quantity and quality necessary for them to survive.